Good evening. Welcome to the online Bible study of Church of God Mission, Lagos Central Bishopric. Our senior pastor is Bishop Sunny Attah. And I'm Reverend John Snomori. I'm the teacher for today. Our topic for today is Bear the Light at Home and Your Community. Repeat again, the topic is Bear the Light at Home and Your Community. Our text for today will be taken from the Gospel according to St. Matthew. Chapter 5 will be taken from verses 13 to 16. And it says, Ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt have lost its savour, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men. Ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on an hill cannot be hid, neither do men light a candle and put under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Brothers and sisters, like I told you, that is our text for today. Our topic again is Bear the Light at Home and Your Community. I want to break it down into three parts. One is Bear the Light, the other one is your home, and the other one is community. I start with Bear the Light. Bear the Light is showing forth who you are. That is your character, your utterances, respect for others, junior, senior, and your colleagues. Then the home is yourself, your spouse, your children, the addendums that people that live with you at home, and also your extended family. The community where here is where you live, your place of origin, that is your town, your village, your state, or your country, if you are a foreigner. Your place of worship, that is your church, stroke your fellowship center. And also, I want to include here, part of your community, your place of work, that is the office where you get your daily bread. So, as we go into the topic, I pray that the Lord will help us. We'll be able to discern what we want to talk about today. And at the end, all of us will be blessed in that precious and wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Again, I want to say, Father, bless your word. As your word comes forth, let it come with power. Let it come that anyone that will hear your word today will not remain the same. At the end, your name alone be glorified in that precious and wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Now, we're going to look at people that did not bear the light at home, as your community, and those that will bear the light at home and in their community. First, I want to take from the book of Samuel. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 12 to 17. We'll not read. We'll just look at later. You can look at it by yourself. This one talks about the sons of Eli. Their father could not control them. The man was not bearing the light at home. He was a priest of God. The children were supporting him, but they were doing things that were not palatable to God. They were not acceptable based on the word of God, but he could not stop them. That is the man that could not bear the light at home. If you look at Proverbs 31 verses 1 to 31, that was the teachings of King Lemuel's mother. King Lemuel's mother sat Lemuel down and taught him what life should be. That is bearing light at home, brothers and sisters. Another one is Genesis chapter 18 verses 17 to 19. That is where God testified of Abraham. God said, I know that Abraham will teach his descendants, will teach his children about me, about the word of God, about the right things that should be done. That's a man that will bring the light at home and his community. Then look at Genesis chapter 9, verses 20 to 27. That one talks about Noah. Noah, we all know, was a great man. He was the only man that survived the flood. But yet, he was drunk in presence of his children. One of them mocked him, while the other two did not mock him. At the end, one of them was cursed. The other two learned what their father taught them. The other one did not learn. Brothers and sisters, those are the things that you have to look at. That is bearing the light in your house and in your community. I bring it down to our what we do today, brothers and sisters. Let me tell you, some of us will go to our villages. We join them to do masquerade. They're not bearing the light in your community. In your house, you tell your children to go and buy you a cigarette. You tell your children to go and buy you beer. Alcohol. We are Pentecostals. We don't take alcohol, brothers and sisters. We don't take cigarettes. If you do all those things, tell your children to do, your children will do worse than that. Your children will do worse than that. So, bearing the light at home, like I wrote down here, I said, you have to teach your household the way of the Lord. We were told in Jeremiah chapter 35, verses 5 to 9, where the children of Jonadab and the son of Rechab, God told Jeremiah, go and tell them to drink wine. They told Jeremiah that we cannot drink wine because our father Jonadab told us that we must not drink wine. We, our wives, our sons, and our daughters, and everyone who stays with us, they must not drink wine all the days of our life. Therefore, we will not drink. Jonadab taught them. They relied on it, they carried it forward, and not until that they did not even succumb to as great as prophet Jeremiah was. Are you here today? Do you teach your children great things? The things you are teaching your children, are you sure they will carry it forward? If you yourself do not do the right thing, brothers and sisters, I want to let you know that there's no way your children can do the right thing. I don't read that here. That don't tell them to do what you say. Let them see what you are doing, brothers and sisters. Let them see what you are doing. The burying Jews, when you read the Bible to them, when you teach them, when you preach to them, they will go and check the Bible. Is that what the Bible says? If you say they should do that, and you are not doing the same thing, they will not do it. So, brothers and sisters, teach your children, teach your members of your household. Let your community know the right thing to be done. You have somebody is married. We remember somebody that died in an air crash some time ago. He had a wife in Lagos. He had a girlfriend or a concubine in Abuja. He claimed to be a Christian, a pastor for that matter. Is that a good life? No, brothers and sisters. Therefore, you must do what you wanted to do and not say what you wanted to say. You cannot, like I told you, you cannot drink alcohol and tell your children not to drink. They will follow suit. You cannot beat your wife also, men that beat their wife, and also wife that beat their husbands. That is vice versa. You cannot do it. That is, you must bear the light at home. Bear the light at home, the light of Jesus. The light cannot be hidden. When you live a good life, a godly life, a life that is worthy of emulation, you find out that people, your children will follow suit. Your negative trait, if you display a negative trait in the presence of your children, they will follow suit. If you do it in the presence of your wife follows suit. If you do it in the community, your community follows suit. So of course, go home to our villages. We don't attend churches. We have seen a pastor in church when somebody passed on to glory. We try to call the pastor from one of our churches in that village. They said, this person did not attend church when they get to a village. How do you do that? What light are you bearing in your community? You are a Christian in Lagos, but not a Christian in your village. It is wrong, brothers and sisters. As a man that bears the light, a child of God that bears the light at home and the community, when you go to your village, let them know that you are a child of God. Let them know that you are a child of God. Don't be afraid. Jesus is there to cover you. Tell them that you are a child of God. Don't do what they do. Teach them the right thing to do, the way of the Lord. Teach them the way of the Lord. And every one of them will follow suit. If you teach them the wrong thing, they will do the wrong thing. A day is coming when they are contributing to do anything that is wrong, to do anything that is ungodly, they will tell you to contribute because you did not tell them who you are. You did not show forth who you are. You did not bear the light of Christ in their presence because they know you not to be a Christian. Therefore, they will force you to donate. They will make you be part of what they are doing, and that will destroy your testimony. I want to say here also, brothers and sisters, use the rope when necessary. We are Africans. Use the rope when necessary. Proverbs 23 verse 13 is clearly stated there. If you spare the rod, you spoil the child. When your children are going wayward, there's a time to use rod. There's a time not to use rod. You must recognize when to use rod. I must recognize when not to use rod. Those are the things that people know that you bear the light in your house. When your children come out, people will know them, that these are godly children. These are well brought up children. These are children that their family, their parents bear the light in their houses. Brothers and sisters, that is a good one. Bearing the light in your community. I said, let everyone know who you are. Be a Christian in Lagos and be a Christian in your community. Do not join it to worship by the way you are in your village. Do not join them to carry masquerade when you are in your village. Don't let your masquerade excite you when you are in the village. Let them know that what you are doing is not of God. Go against everything that is ungodly when you get to the village. When you get to your family, everything that is ungodly, go against it. Seriously, go against it. Let them know that it is wrong. People will know that, therefore, that they will not call you for anything anymore because they now know that you bear the light in your community. You bear the light in your community. I wrote down here, advantages of bearing the light in your home or your community. You will have peace of mind. If your children are following the way of the Lord, you will have peace of mind. Your household will manifest God's glory. And to be, they will be anywhere they are, they will be a shining example. Number three, you will win souls for the kingdom of God. When you don't do it with them, you will be able to win them. If you do it with them, if you drink beer with them, you womanize with them, you do every wrong thing with them, every ungodliness with them, you can't win them to the kingdom of God. The day you preach to them, they will tell you we are the same. So if you want to win souls for the kingdom of God, brothers and sisters, you must be able to show forth who you are. Let them know who you are, both in your community, in your house, in your office, anywhere you find yourself. Show forth who you are, and the Lord will help you. We pray that the Lord will bless us, will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The agenda here, number four, the blessings of God upon you will transcend all, will transcend generations. Generation to generation, the children of Jonadab that gave that testimony, in the book of Jeremiah, Elijah were not born when Jonadab lived. Their father's blessing transcends generations, move from generation to generation, and it got to their tongue. Then number five, God will testify of you as he did of Abraham. God testified of Abraham in Genesis chapter 18, verses 17, 18, and 19. He said, I know that Abraham will teach his children. Will God testify of you that he will teach your children? Will God testify of you that he knows that you are going home? He will teach your community the way of the Lord. Those are the advantages, brothers and sisters. It is inexhaustive. You can add more. Then if you don't bear the light at home and in your community, the disadvantages are as follows. Number one, you cannot win any soul. Beelzebub cannot win Beelzebub. The devil cannot win souls for the kingdom of God because he's a devil. Number three, you will incur the wrath of God. You cannot put one leg in the kingdom of God and put one leg in the kingdom of darkness. It cannot happen. Your soul will be in the danger of hell. If you die at a particular time, you have misled souls. Be guaranteed, be assured that you will never see the kingdom of God because you are dying in sin. So please, in the name of Jesus Christ, I appeal to every one of us to bear the light at home and in our community. Anywhere we find ourselves, let us say, do not make this mistake. That as a child of God, anywhere you find yourself, show forth the light. Do not be ashamed. Do not be ashamed at all. Let your children know who you are. In your community, let them know who you are. Anywhere you go, let them know who you are. I've been to a program in Benin. Everybody, the bodies were they were doing a procession. There was a proclamation by one of them on the queue saying, everybody should rise up. I refuse to rise up. Before then, when I was leaving my car, the Lord told me, go back for your sword. I went back for my Bible. And I sat down with God there and said, everybody should get up. I was the only person in the whole gathering that sat down. I told them, I cannot get up for the devil. I'm a child of God. I'm a priest of God. I'm a child of God. I cannot get up for the devil. It's not possible. I show for the light. I encourage others. They have to sit down. Those bone members were looking at me. Say, who is this? The person I greeted before that was exchanged pleasantries. When she was going, she could not greet me again because I'm not one of them. Because I show for the light in my community. My family members know that I'm a child of God. They come to my house. I say, you don't drink beer in my house. You don't smoke cigarette in my house. My house is a holy place. You don't do all this in my house. If you want to go and do it, go outside. And they all obey. They all know me. You can't do it in my presence. I expect that everyone should live the same way, brothers and sisters. Are you living that way? Do you bear the light in your community? Do you bear the light in your house? Do you bear the light in your school? Children, I've seen children of men of God. They are so pious when they come to church. But in the school, they are something. Did their father teach them or their father not teach them? I leave that one for you, every one of us to judge. Brothers and sisters, I want to appeal to every one of us that anywhere we find ourselves, let us bear the light. Let us bear the light, for the light of God is the best thing that can ever happen to any man. It bringeth peace. It bringeth peace, like I've written in my advantages. When your house is full of the light of God, you have peace. When your children will make you happy, it will make you happy. You'll be free from some sicknesses that they cannot affect you. Because when you see your children, you are happy. You know that when you are not there, they will do the right thing. When you're not there, you will do the right thing. Brothers and sisters, thank you for listening to me. That is our study for today. Bear the light at home and in your community. May the word of God be blessed in our lives in the precious and wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, thank you for your word. Let your name alone be glorified. As spoken, King of glory, let it become good seeds in the mind of all of us, myself speaking, and those who are listening to me, so shall it be. Be thou glorified, for in Jesus' most precious and wonderful name I do pray. Amen. Brothers and sisters, I want to tell you that you join us every Sunday at Church of God Mission, Lagos Central Bishopry Headquarters, and number 7, NNPC Road, Ijebu, and all our churches around you. If you are not close enough for our churches, go to any Bible-believing church around you where you will hear the word of God genuinely. Give your life to Christ, and you will be rest assured. May the Lord bless us in Jesus' name. Amen.